We are ready to start working on the first floor of the project. So the first thing we will need to do is to switch to the first floor in order to move the construction plane on that first floor elevation. So now we are going to run the slab command, and as long as we have the project as snap point, we can just select this corner of the slab, the opposite corner of it, and we will draw just a slab on top of it. Now we'll need to subtract some boundaries in order to have the openings for the ramp and stair objects respectively. So we'll just turn this into ghosted, and I'm going to draw with a rectangle command a rectangle on the ramp boundary that I will use to subtract a boundary to the slab. So under the slab command I can run the subtract boundary, select the slab, click enter, select the boundary, and the subtraction has been performed. We can do the same with the stair, but there is a command that automatically generates a boundary curve for the contour of the stair according to specific clearance height. So under the slab command we can find this subtract stair clearance contour, and we will select this slab, this stair, and the stair clearance height could be, for example, 2 meters. And the opening is already generated. If we select the slab and activate its control points, we can see that we have some control points at the corners of the original slab, and also control points on those curves that were used for the subtraction. So in this case we could move them to extend the position of this opening. But in this case I would just draw another rectangle. In this case I'm going to work from the top viewport. I would just make sure that I work also on the first floor and just select it, and I will draw just a rectangle that follows the contour of this stair. So just make it as big as this piece of a slab that goes here. Actually we'll just move this endpoint next to this position, and now I can run the slab subtract boundary command again, select this slab, select this curve, and have exactly the opening as I want it. I can actually select this curve and delete it. We can also subtract a couple of boundaries here for a couple of skylights on here, so we can move to the top viewport, show the first floor bitmap, and just draw a couple of rectangles according to the bitmap for these skylight positions. Now we can run the subtract boundary command again, I select slab and the boundary, and repeat the same operation for the other boundary. If we take a closer look at the slab opening, we can see that it's not meeting the ramp and landing, so we can adjust the position of the slab opening just by editing the slab control points. So we'll select this point and this other point and move them next to the slab ending.